Wide receiver Michael Pittman of the Indianapolis Colts is not likely to stay under the radar for long. In his two games back since suffering a calf injury, he has seen 7 and 8 targets in those games. In the first game back, he had an impressive 4 catches for 56 yards, but he didn't find the end zone in the second game, which was this past week against Tennessee, but he caught 7 balls for 101 yards. What I like about Pittman is he's a big target, and we know Phillip Rivers doesn't have the arm he used to have. Pittman could emerge into a force down the stretch. Over in Miami, wide receiver Jakeem Grant. He is now the number 2 receiver for the Dolphins. Preston Williams is on the injured reserve, so he'll continue to miss time. We don't know how much. And a few weeks ago, they had traded away Isaiah Ford. Grant moved right into the starting role against the Chargers, and he caught 4 of 5 targets for 43 yards and a touchdown. Now, he's tiny, but he can fly. He has sub 4.4 speed, and also that one pass he didn't catch wasn't his fault. He was open for about a 30-yard touchdown, and Tagovailoa just missed him for what could have been 70 yards and 2 touchdowns and a big game. But the lack of that second one keeps him under the radar just a bit longer. Finally, Josh Reynolds of the Los Angeles Rams. Look, when we think about the passing game there, we're thinking about Cooper Kupp. We're thinking about Robert Woods. Reynolds has been the most consistent targeted player on that team over the last 3 weeks. He has seen either 8, 9, or 10 targets in each of the last 3 games. And yes, he's not putting up eye-popping numbers. He did well against the Seahawks with 96 yards, but he has posted at least 44 yards in 5 straight games. And yes, again, not great numbers, but if you need to flex him, if you need him even as a wide receiver 3, he is coming through, he is gaining the confidence of the coaching staff and the quarterback, and he, again, will not stay under the radar for long.